about viral hepatitis or what's called سمي التهاب الكبد الفيروسي. Viral hepatitis in general caused by five type of hepatotrophic hepatotropic viruses, which is hepatitis A, B, C, D, and E viruses. The most common here A, B, and C. D and E is rare cause for hepatitis. We start with most common type of this viral hepatitis, which is hepatitis A. Hepatitis A is caused by RNA virus, which is hepatitis A virus. About the epidemiology of this viral infection, a transmission is almost always by person-to-person contact through the fecal-oral route. It is a route of transmission from one to another by fecal-oral route only. Infection has been associated with contact with contaminated food or water. يعني من نقل من شخص إلى شخص أما عن طريق contaminated food or contaminated water with the virus. Also after travel to endemic area. Also contact with infected person in child care centers. يعني child care center يعني دور الحضانة. Household contact اللي موجودين بالبيت. فأني contact with this patient can transmit this infection. This virus excreted in the stool from 2 weeks before to 7 days after onset of jaundice. And the patient is therefore contagious during this period. يعني خلال هذه الفترة اللي هي 2 weeks قبل لا يبدي jaundice و 1 week after onset of jaundice هي هاي ال period of infectivity واللي ممكن بها الشخص transmit the infection to another one. Clinical manifestation of hepatitis A, incubation period about 3 weeks. After this incubation period, the systemic symptoms will appear. And systemic symptoms could non-specific manifestation like fever, malaise, nausea, emesis or vomiting, anorexia, and abdominal discomfort. Diarrhea also often occur in some children. After that, the jaundice will appear. يعني مو من البداية راح يبدي عندنا jaundice. بالبداية تبدي عندك systemic symptoms. Then specific, after that the jaundice will appear with dark color urine with pale stool occur. طبعا dark color urine it is occur due to bile pigment which is excreted in the urine and pale color stool. And develop after systemic symptoms, this jaundice and change in color of urine. In addition to that, there is right upper quadrant pain at the site of the liver due to hepatitis. So there will be pain at the site of the liver in the right upper quadrant. This is a patient with viral hepatitis. And as we say, this yellowish discoloration in the sclera and in the skin. This is the jaundice. And this is the dark color urine, which is occur in case of hepatitis due to bile pigment. Normal color of urine, as we know, it is amber color, يعني faint yellow, كون الكلام مالته. Typical duration of the illness is about 7 to 14 days. كل هذه signs and symptoms ممكن تستمر عندنا 1 to 2 weeks. Rarely in this case of hepatitis, other system can be affected like lymphadenopathy or splenomegaly, also aplastic anemia, but this is in rare cases. Fulminant hepatitis or acute hepatic failure, it is uncommon in children due to hepatitis A. But co-infection with hepatitis C virus, co-infection that means infection occur at the same time. يعني عند hepatitis A وبنفس الوقت hepatitis C infection. This is increase the risk for fulminant acute hepatitis. Hepatitis A not associated with chronic liver disease. So فقط acute infection, not cause chronic infection or intestinal carrier state. As other viral infection اللي راح نتكلم عنه. For diagnosis of this viral infection, كل اللي تقريبا الفيرال هيباتيتس نعتمد بالدايجنوسيس على الديتكشن اوف انتيبوديز اجينست فيروس اند انتيجين. So المين diagnostic test by serological assay. In case of hepatitis A, we can detect antibodies to hepatitis A virus, which is IgM, which is appear in the acute stage, and then change into the IgG antibodies by radioimmunoassay. In this figure, we see the response of hepatitis A, response to hepatitis A infection. And as we see, after incubation period, which is about 3 weeks, their systemic symptom will appear. During the period from 2 weeks before symptoms appear, into about 1 week after jaundice appear. هذه هي الانفكتيفيتي period of infectivity. يكون بها الشخص infectious وممكن ينقل الانفكشن for another one. 2 weeks before jaundice appear, 1 week after jaundice appear. طبعا خلال هذه الفترة the hepatitis A virus will shed in the stool, excreted in the stool. And antibodies, which is IgM antibodies, it's appear يعني before systemic symptoms appear, يبدي يساعدنا ان ال IgM it will be then بدي decline and IgG antibody will be increase. We can also do identification of viral particles in the stool. We can isolate it. Viral PCR assay to detect the RNA of the virus. We can also do liver function test due to the problem in the liver, hepatitis. So there will be an increase in the bilirubin level, hyperbilirubinemia. The hyperbilirubinemia in this case either mixed يعني نقصد two type will increase, conjugated and unconjugated. Or it is mainly conjugated hyperbilirubinemia, mainly اللي راح يزيد هو direct bilirubin أو conjugated bilirubin. Also, there is raised in the serum level of liver enzyme, which is AST and ALT, in addition to alkaline phosphatase. We have some complication for this viral infection. In the hepatitis A, who is the most common type in our society, who is the most benign one. So most patients will achieve full recovery without any complication, but rarely complication will occur in form of acute liver failure. It can be occur in hepatitis A, but it is rare. Also, there is sometimes edema and ascites due to hypoalbuminemia. Due to infection occur in the liver, so the synthetic activity or function of the liver will be affected sometime, decrease albumin synthesis. The albumin synthesized by the liver. So in case of hepatitis, it can be decreased, lead to hypoalbuminemia, or ممكن أنه lead to edema and ascites in case of hepatitis A. For treatment of this viral infection, we have no specific treatment for hepatitis A. مو كل patient عنده hepatitis A أحتاج أدخله المستشفى. Not need to admission for hospital only in some cases. مثلا الطفل عنده repeated vomiting and cannot take any oral feeding. So we need to admit for IV fluid. Or sometime if the liver function is affected. احنا قلنا ممكن انه هو lead to acute fulminant hepatitis. So when there is liver affected, prothrombin time يطلع عندنا prolong. In this case also need to admit to hospital. Otherwise not need admit and treat at home symptomatic treatment. For prevention of this viral infection, first we should isolate the patient. Patients should be excluded from school, childcare, or work during contagious period. This by give him sick leave. يعني الطفل إذا كان مصاب تنطي إجازة مرضية لمدة ايش قد يحتاج هو خلال كل الكونتاج هو سبيريد. ثم عاده من يجي يراجع او من تبدي عنده ساين سيمتوم، يعني من يبدي يطلع الجوندز عند الطفل يشوفوا الاهل، يلا ذاك الوقت ياخذوا للطبيب، او من يبدي عنده فوميتنج والفيبر. فتقريبا افتر ابييرنس اوف سيمتوم ايش قد يحتاج فتره يكون بها كونتاج هو 1 ويك از وي سي previously. So it need to exclude it from school or from childcare or from work for this contagious period. Due to it is transmitted by fecal oral route, so careful hand washing, particularly after changing the diaper of the child and before preparing the food, this is very important. يعني ممكن هو هذا اللي ينقل لنا الانفكشن for another one. The other line for prevention is the vaccine. We have two inactivated hepatitis A virus vaccine are approved for children more than 2 years of age. The other types of hepatitis, it is hepatitis B. And it is caused by hepatitis B virus. And this virus is DNA virus, double strand. The surface of this virus include particles designated as hepatitis B surface antigen. إذا surface مال هذا الفيروس يحتوي على particles نسميها hepatitis B surface antigen. The inner portion of the virion contain hepatitis B core antigen. هذا بالداخل hepatitis B core antigen. The nucleocapsid that encode the viral DNA called hepatitis B E antigen, which is served as a marker of active viral replication. إذن عندنا three type of antigen in hepatitis B. Hepatitis B virus, hepatitis B surface antigen, hepatitis B core antigen, hepatitis B E antigen. These three antigen is important in the diagnosis and follow up of the patient. وراح نتكلم عنها during the diagnosis of this infection. About the epidemiology of this type of hepatitis, transmission will occur through blood and the blood products. So route of transmission, not by fecal-oral route as hepatitis A, it is transmitted mainly by blood and the blood product. Blood product, نقصد بها cryoprecipitate, platelet, بلازما، وهذه كلها ممكن نستخدمها في medical condition، خصوصا البيشنت اللي عندهم bleeding tendency. مثلا عندنا hemoglobinopathy thalassemia، sickle cell anemia، الهيموفيليا، bone well brand disease. كل دول يحتاجون عادة إلى frequent blood or blood product transfusion. It's grown more risky for these viruses. Also transmitted by sexual contact. IV drug addict by sharing the needle. الأدكت اللي هم المدمنين share the needle of the syringe اللي يستخدموها، وهذه ممكن ينقل الانفكشن from one to other. Also tattoos. التاتوز اللي هو تاتوين أيضا sharing the needle. الneedle اللي يستخدمه ممكن إنه هنا نستيرايل من شخص إلى شخص infected ينقل إلى another one. Intimate contact with carrier. Intimate mean close contact with carrier state. أيضا ممكن ينقل الفيروس. Transplacental transmission from hepatitis B surface antigen positive mother. And the risk of transmission is greatest if the mother also has hepatitis B E antigen positive. يعني إذا كانت الأمية مصابة عندها hepatitis B، إذا أكو عندها بالبلد hepatitis B surface antigen positive. هذا الانتيجين هو اللي راح ينقل عن طريق البلاسنتا ويسبب لي الانفكشن عند الطفل. الترانسميشن اوف ذيس انفكشن او الريسك اوف ترانسميشن يكون جريتست اف ذا مذر also has hepatitis B E antigen due to it mean active viral replication as we say previously. Hepatitis B surface antigen is recovered in the breast milk of infected mothers. يعني إذا الأم كانت عندها hepatitis B, this virus will excreted or this antigen, hepatitis B surface antigen excreted in the breast milk. But this is not contraindicated for breastfeeding. ما راح توقف الرضاعة عن الطفل. يعني إحنا immediately after delivery إذا كانت الأم هي hepatitis B immediately after delivery you should send investigation for the baby. رأسة تدز تحاليل للطفل حتى تتأكد إذا كان مصاب أو لا. If the baby is not infected, so immediately you should give him hepatitis B immunoglobulin and hepatitis B, the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine. And we can continue. طبعا نعطيها المفروض within 12 hours after delivery. Immediately within 12 hours. And we can give him breastfeeding. يعني انت راح تعطيه immunoglobulin، تعطي vaccine، تقدر الامية تستمر بالbreastfeeding. اذا كان مصاب هو بعد مصاب فبعد ما نحتاج نعطي الفاكسين او الاميونوجلوبولين. So it is not contraindicated if the mother hepatitis B, not contraindicated for breastfeeding. Clinical manifestation of this viral infection, it is about 45 to 160 days. And the first clinical evidence which is appear is elevation of liver enzyme, which is ALT. Also there is lethargy, anorexia, and malaise. Then the jaundice will appear, which usually began about 8 weeks after exposure and lasts for 4 weeks. The illness may be preceded by arthralgia or skin lesion like urticaria or papular acrodermatitis. Sometimes there is extra hepatic manifestation in hepatitis B like polyarthritis, glomerulonephritis, or aplastic anemia. Chronic carrier states. Hepatitis B can cause chronic carrier state. And this defined as positive for hepatitis B surface antigen of cases. يعني إذا شخص أو طفل مصاب عنده hepatitis B يبقى عنده لما راح نسوي له يعني follow up with treatment. If hepatitis B surface antigen remain positive for more than 6 months, صار لأكثر من 6 أشهر وعنده أيضا hepatitis B still hepatitis B surface antigen positive, هذا نعتبره chronic carrier state. On physical examination, when I examine the child with hepatitis B, there will be ecteric skin on the mucous membrane, which means jaundice, hepatomegaly with tenderness in the right hypochondrium, splenomegaly and lymph adenopathy can also be present. In complicated cases, clinical sign of altered sensorium and hyperreflexia, which is indicate encephalopathy and acute liver failure. This is only in complicated cases. For diagnosis of this viral infection, also like hepatitis A, we depend on serological markers. The first was detection of hepatitis B surface antigen. This is the first serological marker which appear after infection. أول واحد يظهر عندك بالسيرم هو hepatitis B surface antigen after infection. Also, we can detect antibody to hepatitis B core antigen, which is IgM and IgG antibodies, and hepatitis B E antigen. Anti-hepatitis B surface antibody and anti-hepatitis B core antibody are detected in person with resolved infection. While person immunized with hepatitis B vaccine have only anti-hepatitis B surface antibodies. يعني إذا شخص مثلا صار عنده hepatitis B infection previously سابقا يعني and resolved infection, cure the patient. من تيجي تسوي له serological marker راح تلقى عنده anti-hepatitis B surface antibody and anti-hepatitis B core antibodies. إذا شخص ماخذ immunization, لقاح of hepatitis B. انت تجي تسوي له serological marker راح تلقى عنده فقط الانتي hepatitis B surface antibodies. اذا اذا لقينا الانتي hepatitis B core antibodies موجوده معناها صاير عنده previous infection سابقه and معناها ماخذ لقاح الشخص بس ما مصاب سابقا. We can also do hepatitis B virus DNA can detect it in the serum, and also we can do liver function test. And as in case of hepatitis A, there will be an increase in bilirubin, hyperbilirubinemia, mixed or conjugated type. There is elevation in the liver enzyme. This figure also shows the response for hepatitis B infection, and as we say, after period of infectivity, the systematic symptom will appear. The first serological marker will appear, who will hepatitis B surface antigen. After that, the anti-hepatitis B core antibodies will appear. اللي يطلع عندنا بالacute stage will IgM and then IgG. Also, can detect the hepatitis B E antigen in the serum and anti-hepatitis B E antibodies. We have some complication for hepatitis B due to it can cause chronic carrier state. First, acute liver failure, which occur more frequently with hepatitis B than others virus. يعني أكثر واحد بالviral hepatitis ممكن يسبب لي acute hepatic failure هو hepatitis B. Other complication, as we say, chronic hepatitis. And chronic hepatitis after many years can lead to liver cirrhosis, end-stage liver disease, and later on, primary hepatocellular carcinoma. Renal complication like membranous glomerulonephritis, and this is occur due to circulating immune complex, which is a rare complication of hepatitis B. Treatment of this viral infection, acute infection, treatment by supportive treatment only. Chronic hepatitis B should be treated by drug, and here we use interferon alpha. Interferon alpha هو نوع من الاميونوثيرابي. Well, other drug هو lamivudine, and this used in children older than 2 years of age. هذه التو drug نستخدمها فقط in case of chronic hepatitis B, not in acute case. For prevention of hepatitis B infection, first by doses first at birth, وبعدين ب 2 months, 4 months, we give, or 6 months العفو. Infant born to hepatitis B, as we say previously, infant born to hepatitis B antigen positive women should receive vaccine at birth accompanied by hepatitis B immunoglobulin as soon as after. لكن إذا طلع not affected هنا نعطي first dose of hepatitis B vaccine and hepatitis B immunoglobulin. Post exposure prophylaxis also sometimes we need to give hepatitis B vaccine and immunoglobulin for household, sexual, needle sharing contact, those with blood exposure and immune compromised patient after exposure. The third and last type of hepatitis we talk about, احنا ما راح نتكلم عن hepatitis B or E because it is rare infection. Most common هما the three types. So hepatitis C, previously known as transfusion related non-A, non-B hepatitis. سابقا كان يسموه هذا الاسم لأنه mainly transmitted by transfusion, blood transfusion. It is caused by hepatitis C virus, which is single-strand RNA virus. Risk factor for transmission includes blood transfusion, the main routes by for transmission of blood transfusion or blood products, اللي ذكرناها اللي هي cryo, plasma, platelet, anemia. Also, illegal drug use with exposure to blood from hepatitis C virus infected individual by using shearing needle. In case of addiction, sexual transmission, occupational exposure, وأنا أقصد به هنا medical staff يعني اللي يتعاملون ويا الأشخاص المصابين، مثلا اللي يشتغلون بالمراكز الدم الوراثية أو بالمختبرات، يتعاملون ويا البيشنت اللي ممكن يكونون مصابين بسبب الفريكوينت بلاد ترانسفيوجن أو بلاد برودكت، اللي هم يشملون الميديكال ستاف. اكسيدنتالي ممكن باي نيدل أو أني تشيك باي سكين ابريجن ممكن ينقل الفيروس فور ذيس person. Perinatal transmission from mother to her infant and cause congenital viral infection also can occur. Clinical manifestation for this infection, the incubation period is about 7 to 9 weeks. Acute liver failure rarely occur in case of hepatitis C. Hepatitis C is the most likely virus to cause chronic infection. أكثر شيء أكثر واحد بالفيرال هيبيتايتس فيروسز اللي يسبب كرونيك انفكشن هو هيبيتايتس سي، وممكن تكون كرونيك انفكشن without any sign on symptom. يعني شخص يكون مصاب ويحمل الفيروس بس ما عنده أي sign or symptom، ممكن discover accidentally. يعني من يسوون searching for medical staff اللي معرضين مثل ما قلنا على occupational risk، وممكن يكتشفون كم واحد مصاب بس هو ما عنده اي ساين سيمتوم، تشوفه اكسيدنتال. كرونيك هيباتيتس سي فيروس انفكشن از ديفاين باي بيرسيستنتلي اليفيتد ليفل اوف اي ال تي ان ذا بريزنت اوف هيباتيك فايبروسيس اند باي بريزنت اوف هيباتيتس سي فيروس ار ان اي ان ذا بلاد فور مور ذان 6 مانث. هذا نعتبره كرونيك انفكشن. And for diagnosis, we depend also on serological tests to detect the antibodies for hepatitis C virus antigen and PCR to detect small amount of hepatitis C virus RNA. This picture shows the changes in the liver in case of a chronic infection, chronic hepatitis B or chronic hepatitis C infection. This is the healthy liver. It will be changed into the fatty liver and lastly into the cirrhosis. طبعا cirrhosis ممكن بعدين later on into hepatocellular carcinoma. We can also do liver function test as another viral infection. Liver biopsy to assess the presence or extent of hepatic fibrosis. ممكن إذا treated هو patient واصل مرحلة صاير عنده fibrosis or cirrhosis، ممكن نحتاج liver biopsy حتى نشوف in which stage of liver cirrhosis he reached. The complication of this viral infection, the first and the most common complication is chronic hepatitis, as we say, which is occurring in about 60 to 80% of cases. يعني إحنا قليل نشوف acute hepatitis C infection. أكثر شيء تجينا chronic infection. Cirrhosis, as we say, and later on hepatocellular carcinoma. Well, acute hepatic failure, this is a rare complication in case of hepatitis C. For treatment. Treatment of chronic hepatitis C, we can use interferon alpha and ribavirin for children more than 3 years of age. Prevention of this viral infection, we have no vaccine is available to prevent hepatitis C virus. احنا عندنا vaccine for hepatitis A, for hepatitis B is available, موجود ومتوفر يعني. Hepatitis C, we have no vaccine for this viral infection, so preventive measure is important to protect ourselves from this viral infection, especially medical staff who deal with patients infected with this virus. And thank you for listening. طلاب عندنا كويز اليوم. بس لحظة حتى ننزل الأسئلة.